Hello folks, this is Best in Slot, and in this video we're going to take a look at the entirety of the brand new Arctic pack for Planet Zoo. That's 4 brand new animals and over 200 construction and nature items. I'm going to show you the absolute whole lot in this video. We're going to start off the animals, then we'll look at the building items and stuff a little bit later on. There is a lot to get through, so we're going to keep it snappy, but I think you guys are going to love this pack. It came out this morning, it's $10, I believe, so that thing is flying. Anyways, so 4 new animals. We're going to kick things off with the reindeer, and you have to really, don't you? It's a quintessential Arctic, Christmassy sort of animal. We're not going to talk about the new construction items, you can see, because we will have a bit on there, but yeah, let's grab this guy at the back here. There you go, folks. That is our brand new reindeer. Yet more hoofed ungulates, but you know what? These ones are amazing. I love them, and they're called reindeer, not caribou in-game, which is just a nice little nod to the Britishness of Frontier, and well, non-Americanness, I guess. Anyways, the reindeers look really, really, really good. We can pause them for a second, take a closer look up here at the fur. This is one of the few times the fur shader is actually working the way I would like it to work. It looks furry but fluffy and hairy at the same time. It's kind of working for me, but it's absolutely adorable. The horns are really cool, really well made. I'm hoping we've got a little bit of genetic variation in there, but we'll have to wait and see. The head is large and in charge, but that's obviously some male. That's Milka. We do have some females knocking around. There's Ada right there, looking adorable. And we also have some babies. You're going to see the babies for all 4 new species today, because I've prepared for that. You can see just a little bump where the horns are going to be down the line. Super cute. Okay, that one's on the move. Let's look at Pavy instead. There's Pavy, our baby reindeer. Not going to try to talk too much. I just want to show you all these animals, and then we can get onto the construction items as well. But they're really, really cool. Look at the little fluffy tails, like a bunny rabbit. Ah, moving on from the reindeer then. Goodbye, my friends. We shall go look at the... We'll save the polar bears for last. We're going to go look at the Arctic wolves. So, once again, we have some babies here. We have a pack led by a dominant male. There's our female, Nuva. I really, really like the colouring on the fur here. The kind of shades of brown and yellow and kind of creamy colours coming through. It's not just white. It's a complex, multicoloured, in some ways, animal. No, it's not a rainbow, but it's an interesting animal to look at. It really is. Really, really cool. Is that the male? Yeah, that's Sikinik. Sikinik. It's an amazing name. Our Arctic wolf. That's our pack leader. Dominant alpha right there, living on his own. Yeah, they look really cool. I don't know if there's new animations and stuff compared to the other wolves. But, there are model differences. There's definitely texture differences, obviously. And we can go take a look at the babies as well. Now, I will warn you, the babies are mildly terrifying. This is our Nakuagsak. The eyes. The eyes. They freak. Look at it. It's terrifying. They're adorable. But in a way that you think they'd kill you if they got half the chance, you know? They're very, very cute, though. What are you up to, buddy? Where are you off to? How you living? And just wagging his tongue around. Really happy in environments like this. There still isn't that many Arctic foliage options in the game at all, unfortunately. We did get some really cool new Arctic nature stuff, which I'll show you at the end. But in terms of foliage, we're still quite limited. But they are very happy in what is a fairly limited design-wise exhibit anyway. But the eyes. Anyways, that's the Arctic wolf. We can shuffle on a little further and we can check out the Dall Sheep. I actually love these. These are my surprise contender for best animal in the pack. I really, really like them because they just look so different than everything else we currently have in the game. So there's one of our males. Those horns, those ram horns are just so cool. The spiral, the texturing is amazing. Like, if we just zoom in a little bit, look at them. They're really, I mean, up close they go a little bit blurry, but yeah, that's to be expected. They look awesome. There's little black pock marks by the eyes. Even the eye, the pupil shape has that kind of, what do you call it? I don't know what the official term is, but this sort of elongated, flattened pancake kind of look that sheep and goat and such have. The females right there as well, like a little bit more, oh, the tongue thing, a little bit more chill in terms of the horns, and of course, oh, we have some babies of the sheep as well. How could you not love these guys? The little horns again, and the black pock marks. It is the cutest little thing. And that noise, that sound effect. Honestly, one of my top 5 favorite animals in the entire game. I don't know why this is resonating so deeply with me. Maybe because I grew up on the Elf Man and all we have there is sheep, but yeah, these are super, super cute and going to be very, very popular, I think. Oh lord, he's moving. Right, so that is the Dall Sheep. Oh, the Dall Sheep. I will show you the social and stuff very quickly once we're done here as well, so you can plan your exhibits out if that's what you want to do. Because you're going to need to for one of our animals. This here is the polar bear exhibit. This here is the minimum-ish. It's slightly bigger, but not by much. You'll see it. This is about the amount of room you'll need for a polar bear. They require immense amounts of space. Absolutely immense. And then they're just going to gather around here where the food is. I'm not sure if it's a bug or if it's more meant to reflect the sort of the kind of distances a polar bear does realistically cover, because they do cover insane distances. But it is incredible. It really is. Anyways, Tanarak, our female polar bear. She's been caught up a little bit. Poor Tanarak. Yeah, I love the polar bear. How can you not love a polar bear? It's a quintessential... Oh, look at that baby! It's a quintessential zoo animal. The only problem with the polar bear is we already have several bears, and it's just like a white version at the end of the day. But I do very much love them. It's got like a shorter snout. You know, it's distinctively a polar bear. And the baby... The baby... paddling along. You just had to wait until I was recording to get moist, didn't you? You could have chosen not to get moist. There you go, there's a snoozy polar bear for you. So, whilst you're looking at that, and cooing, I'm sure. Oh, we'll take a quick little look at their Zoopedia. So, actually, we're already on the polar bear. 1 to 2, polar bears fight over mates. They're promiscuous. So, just you're only going to have 2 adults. And as soon as your kid grows up, you are, of course, going to have to get rid of them. You could have 2 females together, but you can't have 2 males together. The Arctic wolf, I think similar to the other wolf. 2 to 8, up to 8 males, up to 8 females. Alpha male and alpha female. Again, this pack size of males and females is possible. Basically, you're only going to want 1 male, as far as I'm aware. Or they will keep fighting for it. But you could have like 8 males together on their own, that would be fine. But if you chuck a female in there, that's when things are going to get a little bit messy. The Dall Sheep, 3 to 40. Again, only 1 male if you're going to have females. But, you know, you can get tons of these. And yeah, I've got this big curved horn stag kind of dominating the roost. It's pretty cool. And we also have 1 more to go. Reindeer, 3 to 12. Again, 1 male, 11 females. Men really just live on their own permanently in the animal kingdom, as it happens. You either live with tons of women, or you live on your own. Aw, right, okay. Oh, before my throat explodes. I'm going to grab the baby. I'm sorry, buddy, I really am. I'm just going to move you over here. And you're on your way out. Anyway, just, we need to see the baby. He's a little fluff ball. Even while moist, he's an adorable little fluff ball. I think these are really cool. Again, the sheep is probably my, the doll sheep is probably my favourite of the bunch. Well, the polar bear looks great. It really suits this environment. You could build much nicer exhibits, of course. I kind of just want to showcase everything. First things first, we have 2 new types of path. We've got, tell you what, we'll kind of go through this as I showcase it, but we've got this, what is it called? Yeah, this is the frosted ice path. Ice path? The frosted ice path. And there's one that looks fairly similar. If you get down into the texture, looks like that. We've got a new wooden block path this world that looks something like this. Kind of suits this. You're going to see this a lot, but there's a bit of a Viking settlement theme going throughout this entire park. And, you know, this is the path you would probably use for that. This, if I had to say there's 2 primary themes, it's like Ice Palace and Viking Settlement. Those are the 2 themes you're going to be messing with. So, you know, can see how that one's the Vikings, and this is, of course, your Ice Palace. And we've got some new stuff as well. We've got some new Arctic benches, and, you know, an Arctic canopy thingamajiggy, and an Arctic bin. You'll see what I mean here. This kind of, like, carving into the side, very Viking. Right, so let's go look at 10,000 construction items. So, we're going to start over here. This is just the... We're going to scoot through these fairly quickly. This is a good example, though, of what you're going to be building using this pack. This is, of course, the staff sort of templates you get. You know, the ready-made ones you can put down. This is what they all look like. Very exciting stuff. Tell you what, if we just shift the time of day a little bit... There you go, look at that. Beautiful. So these are all the staff buildings. One of my favourite things here. They look really cool. Again, very Viking, but I love these little torches. I think these are really cool. The Arctic wall light. So it's still meant to be a normal light, but it resembles a burning torch. I think that's really cool. I'm going to, yeah, going to make some really cool exhibits with that. I'm going to say the word cool a lot in this video. We're just going to have to move past it. But yeah, don't want to spend too long on these, just because, no, why would you? But... if you choose to use templates for your park, then you should be pretty happy. And again, this is kind of just showing you how you would want to build with this stuff more than anything else. We also have the exhibit animal thingamajiggies here. Here's a small one, a couple of large ones, and a couple more buildings down here at the end. So there's the bathroom, which is possibly my favourite of the bunch. As it happens, looks great. So that's it for those. If we shuffle back over here, not allowed to look over there yet, and we drop down, we've got three new shelter templates. Before we get to the actual construction items, we've got this one, which is, you know, I don't know, it kind of looks like a half-built ship kind of thing to me. I don't know, it's a bit odd. It's kind of destroyed side areas. This one, which is a really good display of the new Ice Palace sort of theme going on there. Very, very, very cool, I think you'll agree. This is going to light up at night as well and look awesome. And we've got another much nicer shelter, in my opinion. Just a little Viking settlement hut thingamajiggy. Your animals can go and sleep in there. And, of course, that's what we've got over there. Right. In terms of foliage, these are the only options. This is literally it for foliage. And it's three new types of tree. Oh, I should just mention. So, if you go into nature now, you got DLC. So, I think you will see the DLC items, even if you've not purchased them. But you can turn that off. There's actually, if you go into your filters now, a content pack tab, and you can click Arctic Pack. So if you only wanted to use things from the new pack, or you just want to see what was new, you can do so really easily. It's really cool. We're going to come back and look at these in a little bit, but these are three new types of tree, all very similar to each other, but they are very Christmassy. They've got baubles and lights in there, and little red berries and stuff like that. They're very, very cool. We also have an ice rock path. It's really more giant hunks of ice more than anything else, which, again, is awesome. Going to build like some little icebergs and stuff like that. It's going to really make our Arctic exhibits come to life in a really cool, unique way. Yeah, look at that. You can make like a proper big ice field with polar bears trekking along it. If we ever get seals and stuff, have them diving in the water beneath the ice layer. You could actually, that is something you could actually do. You just have to kind of duplicate like these all the way along. And then leave, like, you can do this over water and things will walk across it. So you do that, obviously you make it look better, but you do that. You leave a gap, you put the water in there, and every now and again your seal would maybe swim past. Or maybe something else will, if we never get seals. We'll have to wait and see. But the point is, you could do it. We also have even more rocks over here. These are instead kind of like big, you could even say they're rocks covered in snow, but I prefer to think they're kind of bundles of snow that have been compacted down into the shape of rocks. You know when you get really hard snow and it feels like rock, it's so compacted and hardened down? This is that kind of idea, as far as I'm concerned. Or you could use some snowballs, you know, whatever you decide, really. Yeah, again, pretty cool. Just more Arctic. The Arctic options have just expanded massively. It's insane. I did forget a little something. We have a few new habitat items which are lurking around in here. I'll show you those quickly. We have this ball. It's a small ball ice enrichment, which I guess is a toy. I'll knock that around a little bit. We've got a big snowball, same kind of deal. We've got some new Skittles, which are snowmen instead. Super cute. And indeed, we have a new cardboard box, which is instead a gift box enrichment. So that's it for those. Now, still much to see. This pack is huge. I know some people are a bit disappointed we've got, you know, a paid DLC so soon afterwards, but it's so crammed with building content that, yeah, I don't know. I personally am thrilled. Right, so over here we have the new lamppost, the Arctic lamppost, with its two burning torches on the side. Very cool. We've got some icy pillars. You use this when building your ice palace. You know, you've got the construction blocks for it. We're going to look at those in a sec. But you can make some pillars. You've got these carved ice sections and stuff like that. Very cool. Over here we have the planters, your plant pots, basically, and a couple of roof toppers. Big tree, doesn't do anything in particular, it's just a big tree thing, it's cool. And a polar bear. This polar bear will actually light up, very, very cool as well. Again, we'll come back at night time, I'll do a quick run through so you can see everything, but I think it's worth seeing things in the daytime the first time. You need to calm down, son. Over here we have an ice sculpture of a polar bear, and many more ice sculptures over here. Basically, most of the prominent sculptures in the game have been carved again out of ice. The hippo is awesome, but the dodo ice sculpture is by far my favourite. We have a sort of a tree decoration, and kind of more pillars, kind of in the same vein as those ice pillars we saw a second ago, this time for your Viking hut. Some of them with some motifs and carved into them, kind of like totems, very cool. And also some toppings for those as well to hang over your doorways. If we swing behind them, then you'll see the wooden building materials you're going to be using for said hut. You want to combine this with this stuff to build your Viking settlements. I have not shown all those because, you know, they're all the same shape. What you're really seeing here is just the texture. And we can see the same over here. This is the snow brick one. There isn't anything actually made from this in the game. You could make some, like, octagonal igloo looking thing though. I don't know, build like little snowy houses. I think that's pretty cool. Build like an igloo settlement. Everything will be a settlement. And some stuff on there. Let's take a look around here. If we just shift the time of day again, There we go. So we've got, again, it's just little motifs. These are windows. There's our light. It's a little, is that meant to be? Yeah, that's the wolf carving. That's the deer carving. Again, to me, it looks very Viking, Nordic, you know? Very, really cool. Makes me feel like a Skyrim or, is it Dragon? It's not Dragonblight. What's that place in World of Warcraft? Two expansions ago. I cannot remember. Anyways, one of those. I've got a little mini tree. We've got an editable signpost. Sign. As you can see, lovely stuff. Can you change the colour on that? Of course you can. A pretty cool little fabric sign there. And that is our infopedia. No, that's the shop, basically. The thing that covers the front of the shop. And also has a little hat for the shop as well. Otherwise known as a canopy to some people. But I think we all know it as a shop hat. Moving on once again. We are nearly at the end, although this is the big one. We've got a reindeer statue... ish thing. I don't know, it's like a wooden thing. This comes as either a complete piece, or indeed you can actually put it down as individual items, which is pretty cool if you want to use those for God knows what reason. Some little pieces of wood here. These are just, you know, architectural squares made out of wood, basically. There's not much to say on those. Just gives you a little bit more control over the building process. And we've got tons of Christmas stuff. So let's get onto this. So this is the ice wall, as you can see. Really, really cool. Again, if you're going to build... I keep saying the words Ice Palace because I think I'm thinking of James Bond. Which film was it? I think it's Pierce Brosnan's last James Bond film. But they're fighting like an Ice Palace kind of thing. So that's where my mind keeps going. But you can build anything nice and icy. It's very similar to this snow brick, but of course, got this kind of semi-translucence to it. Down here we have more wooden stuff then. So this is, again, more architectural stuff, just half walls and little bits. We've got a doorway. We've got these lovely little trellises. I really like these. These are one of my favourite things in the game. So you use these even you're not doing Arctic. They would be really... I actually just built a trellis, annoyingly enough, in my franchise park. Yeah. Doesn't that look really cool? That's really nice. I mean, this is definitely something you could already have built, but it just makes it a little bit easier. And the corners are really nice. That is our info sign frame. I've got a little Eve there, and another... I think that's another info sign. Yep, there it is. An icy Zoopedia frame. And over here, we're nearly done. We have a door canopy and our door. Down here we have some fabrics. And we have another door down there. Now, onto the Christmas stuff. And there is a lot of Christmas stuff. Up here at the top we have a wreath. Very nice. We have some lights up there. Really, really pretty. Actually, these kind of star... I'm really surprised. They've gone really hard in on the Christmas stuff. They're like just begging us to make a Christmas park. And I know I'm going to do it because... these alone are enough reason. I think they're really cute. we've got... this is actually a whole different series of little lights here. Arctic festive strip lights. I don't know what makes these different than, say, the existing strip lights, but they're a little bit jankier, I'd say. A little bit more uppy-downy. That is an official term. They're pretty cool. I mean, this is what I mean. We've got stockings. We've got this big, beautiful star that'll light up as well. This snowflake that will also light up. These sort of reef garland chain thingamajiggies. We've got a adorable little reindeer with his little scarf. We've got another wreath with a big old orange slice on the front. We've got a lit up festive star right there. We've got some little gifts you can hang up. We've got some ribbons, including this little fancy fellow up here at the top, which again, you can colour in. Amazing. Look at that. Oh god, that's so saccharine, it makes me sick. There we go. Bam. Baller. Oh, it looks like West Ham. Okay, I'm going to colour this appropriately for Liverpool. Give me a minute. There we go, Liverpool. Actually quite a lot of ribbons, as you can see. We've got some baubles. These are giant, I think they're called festive, yep, festive bauble lights. We've got three of those. They don't really light up much, but still pretty cool. Even this little thing, this little festive berries, because why not? Further down, we have another star. We have another star, got like a little wolfy symbol on the front of it. This one's super cute. This one, also super cute. I think that's it for this side. If we swing, oh no, what's that down there? That's another light, never mind. Swing around here. This is the last thing. Swap the time of day slightly. There you go. We have our new sign. So we've got a sign for the reindeer, the doll, the wolf, and the burr. And you've got a new signpost. And it kind of like... it's not great for putting multiple animals in, but you can do it like this. And it kind of attaches at both sides. Like you can see with the polar bear there. I think that's really cool. We've got this little thing here. Did I see that? Oh, the Zoopedia frame. Right. I think that's it. I think that's every item. And that took 20 minutes, so apologies if it's a little bit shoom, but there's so much to look at. So, I mean, look at it. This is everything laid out right there, including the template items, which isn't as important. That right there is mainly the stuff you're going to be building with. That's the new materials you're looking at right there. I think it's great. I think it's an awesome pack. I'm really, really excited to get started on it. Of course, there's actually a couple new campaign missions coming with this pack as well. We'll be playing those a little bit later on today. Last thing we'll do then, nighttime. Let's go have a look, shall we? So you can see here the lights in effect. Don't they look really cool? I think you could build like a... I don't know how many people are going to want to do this, but I want to do this. I'm thinking of... I don't know how many people saw that film... And I've forgotten what it's called. Oh, you're kidding me. These People Go Into the Woods came out like a couple of years ago. The Ritual? The Ritual. And there's like this big... I think it's very Nordic. It is Nordic. There's like this big Nordic sacrifice at the end. You can even do a Midsommar kind of thing. I don't know. I think the addition of flaming torches is actually really cool. I have a thing for lights though, so... you stop being lit up. Nope, right, so moving along. Here are the festive bauble trees. So like I said, these are actually foliage items. These will go... If you've got a North American tundra animal, these will, you know, go into the exhibit perfectly happily. They are normal trees. You can't change the color. Oh, you can change the color. You can totally change the color. I actually did not see that. Oh, that's crazy. Someone asked me before and I... Oh, that's awesome. Oh, that's really cool. I didn't think any of that. Ah! Ah, that's really good. And that's a full... So you can see them here in the Arctic Wolf exhibit. And they're just part of the exhibit. So if you really wanted it to feel Christmassy all year long, you can definitely do that. Let's go check out some of these other... I think we need a new... oh, no, we don't. Sweet. There's our polar bear, then, gently lit up. Kind of like the... Very similar to the bison that we already have. You may have seen that in my franchise mode, too. This is what the baubles look like at night. Like I say, they don't... The default one lights up quite a lot, but the others don't. But the snowflake and that little star there and these lights up here, and especially this bad boy over here, they just light up really nicely. There's our torch on its own as well. Alright folks, I think that's about all I've got to show you. All the new animals, all the new babies, all the new construction items. So cute! yeah, I think that's it. So let me know what you think about the pack in the comments down below. Personally, I love it. I really do. I don't really know what else to say. I accept that it might be turn off people a little bit because it is paid DLC so soon afterwards. But when it's so much stuff added... I don't know, can you... I don't know. Personally, I think it's fine. If you don't want to add it, you're not missing out on much in terms of, you know, you can still play Planet Zoo and have incredible creativity. But if you want even more, and you want some more campaign, and you want four more pretty cool animals, then you can do just that. Future DLC, I would expect not them all to be like this. I would expect cheaper packs that are more focused on adding new animals. I think if we got this much construction stuff every single time, the game would just break from sheer... incredible amounts of construction items. I suspect we may see a balance between packs like this and smaller animal packs, and then maybe even bigger packs that are more of an overhaul, like for example if we do ever get aquatic or flying animals. We'll have to wait and see. I'm really excited about the future of the game though. I've said for a while that the first DLC for Planet Zoo is actually really important because it kind of signifies the future. You know, are we going to be happy with the DLC direction of the game and the support of the game over the next 2 years? If the DLC is this quality for a few years, this is going to be the best creative park builder anything ever made by miles. It probably already is, but I mean, that's so pretty. It makes me feel a little Christmassy. Cool, right. I'm going to go play some of the campaigns, and you'll see that in an hour or two. Until then, thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye.